taken months and months of planning and 4 days of ferrying across equipment to prepare Sydney's Goat Island for a rock and roll onslaught, the likes of which it's never seen before. Some go bad and some come back. The good ones all get taken. I'm calling it blood. You ain't strong enough.
Fucking can't wait.
I'm really pumped.
Screwed up excited.
I'm almost wetting myself.
Like elephant shit in my underwear.
Bit of a tat going on here.
Indeed.
I'm on the ferry with over 300 Foo Fighters fans for what will be the secret concert of the year. Their champagne. The competition winners have taken their spot right at the front of the stage. The excitement is at fever pitch. This massive concert is about to start.
How you doing, guys? This is the Foo Fighters wasting light on the harbour. Now, I'm not sure if you've thought of this, but right now, you're on an island. The ferries are gone, the taxis are gone, and unless you want to swim through the shark-infested waters of Sydney Harbour, you're stuck here. But that's pretty good if you're stuck with one of the greatest rock bands of all time. Are you ready for the Foo? Playing all the songs you love and know and all the great new tracks, it is the Foo Fighters!
Work tomorrow, do you? You sure? Neither do I. It's gonna be a long night. You ready for a lot of music? You wanna hear the new record? We'll be right back. position. This position does no harm.
You got a
should have known that it would end this way. I should have known there was no other way. Didn't hear your warning. Damn, my heart gone deaf. I should have known. Look at the shape you're in. I should have known, but I dove right in. One thing is for certain, as I'm standing here, I should have known. Lay your hands in mine. Heal me one last time. Though I cannot forgive you, yeah. No, I cannot forgive you, yeah. To leave my I should have known I was inside of you. I should have known there was that side of you. Came without a warning, caught me unaware. I should have known I've been here before. I should have known, don't want it anymore. One thing is for certain, as I'm standing here, I should know.
First things first, I just want to apologise for this shit view. It must suck to have to play a gig here tonight.
What a bummer.
Yeah.
What a drag. Look at this.
It's a bit drab, isn't
Ew.
It?
Ugh.
What was the initial reaction when somebody, I guess, came to you and said, do you want to come to Sydney and play a gig on an island?
I said no. Why would we want to do that? Why would we want to go somewhere beautiful on a beautiful day, play music for people that love our music, who want to come and here's play.
So I take it was an instant yes?
Yeah, it was a yes. That joke really didn't pan out. That wasn't as funny as it was supposed to be.
All the fans are here. They want to hear stuff from the new album. But yeah. Do you find that as a band, you're listening and I guess looking for a reaction to see how strong the songs are and what the reaction is?
Well, you definitely see a reaction to certain songs. Like, there's a song called Arlandria, which No one really sort of considered it to be like a single that would be on the radio. But when we play it live, I think the audience of all the new songs, they get off to that one maybe the most. And Rope, now you're starting to see people react to that because it's been around for a couple weeks. But actually, when we first started doing these club gigs, you know, someone said, well, are you going to let people bring in cameras and stuff? And we thought, yeah, sure, why not? You know, I mean, if it's going to get on YouTube, great. So people will be able to hear some of it before it comes out. And now I'll look down and I'll see people singing the words to songs that aren't even out yet.
Looking for a
quiet. Loud as shit, come on, ready? Further, I just had to have this opportunity to say hello, because if I keep fucking talking, we're gonna be here for 5.5 hours, okay? You don't want 5 hours of talking with me. No, you don't. No, you don't. You really don't. I'd rather just play a bunch more songs. This is like the greatest night of my life. Really. I'm gonna sing this song. To the guy with the fucking beard? Really? Am I this? I don't wanna sing this song to? Dude with the beard? Okay, I'll sing a fucking love song to you. Sheesh. Okay, yeah, there he is. Beard guy. Oh yeah, come on up on stage too. Jesus Lord Christ. Hi, beard guy. What's your name?
Jim.
Hi, Jim. I'm going all right. Well, I know. Oh, no, wait, Ray. No. This one's good. I like this one. He can stay. Hey, Jim. Have you ever had another dude that looks just like you sing a love song to you?
I'll let you do it.
Really? Okay. Will you promise to go away when I'm done? Thanks, Jim. No, you don't seem like a stalker. You just look exactly like me with my band t-shirt on. I already have that fucking shirt. We don't need a sub shirt. Sit right there and I'll sing a love song to you. Awkward. Ready, Jim? Oh, yeah, make yourself at home. Can I get you a beer? Yeah? You gotta drink that whole thing with me right now. Ready? Come on, Jim, go. Lie down. All right. God, you Australian girls. Jim, since you're such a super duper fucking fan, You might recognize this song from the second album. The album is called Color and Shape. It was recorded in 1997. And you weren't even fucking born yet, I'm sure. The song's called Up in Arms. And it goes to my bearded girlfriend, Jen. The ring is here, and you, my dear Austin, my friend. It's true, the two of us all back is one again. I was the one who left you, always coming back. I cannot forget you, Jim. Now I am up in arms again. Get the fuck out of here. Lonely. Here's a song that we once played at that fucking opera house around the way. I remember telling my father, yeah, we're playing at the Sydney Opera House. He's like, what? They're fucking letting you in that place? I said, yeah, Dad. Lately, I've been measuring, seems my time is growing thin. Wind me up and watch me spin, watch me spin, watch me spin. Skin and bones, skin and bones, skin and bones, don't you know? Skin and bones, skin and bones, skin and bones, don't you know? I'm just skin and bones.
I'm sure. Your eyes still remind me of angels that hover above. Once again, change from blind to blue. Why can't I let it out? You'll never know where my soul.
not fucking bored, are you?
Shit, we should play a bunch more songs, right? Okay. That's all you had to say, motherfucker. I was gonna say if I could play more songs. Play more songs. Play more songs. Play more. That's all you had to say.
What if I say I'm not like the others? What if I say I'm not just
If you know it, sing it. Well, I've got another confession to make. I'm your fool. Everyone's got the chains to break, holding you. Were you born to resist?
The best, the best, the best of you. Someone I'm not about to blow it now. For all the cash, for all the cash. It's funny how money allows all to crack and be held down. This wish is true, it falls into pieces new. The cavalier, the cavalier. Oh! You're all a painted doll, and it caused the walls to fall. How far is he impatiently? That's as far as far can be. As far, oh! We'll be right back.
This is a good opportunity for us to be the band that we actually are, a fucking loose, sloppy, barefoot fucking rock band. Thank you very much for letting us do that. We'll come back anytime. Actually, I think, you know what we'll do? When the next record comes out and it's fucking huge, we're just gonna buy Goat Island and then we can do this once a week. What do you think about that shit? We usually like to end it where it all began.
Visiting is pretty. Visiting is good. Seems that all they ever have. Swedish. They rock.
Thank you, it was excellent.
It was unbelievable. That was fucking awesome. I played for ages. And stuff.
Sorry, sorry, girl.
No complaints, man. No complaints. Foo Fighters deliver.
It was the most beautiful thing. It was just sunny as we got here, and then sunset, and it was just ended in darkness. It was amazing.